I don't know what I'm gonna do with you. One day I will run out of duck jokes. Even now I'm struggling to find a stupid joke about a rubber duck. A rubber duck. A rubber duck. Yeah.
Perfect.
A masterpiece.
The rubber duck.
Why do humans love music? When we listen to music, our brains release dopamine. This phenomenon is like a reward for those moments where you behave in a way that increases your survival, like when you have sex or when you eat. But music is not biologically necessary, so why do we like it? Music is a mix of harmonies, melodies, rhythms, and repetitions. Music is based on patterns, and us humans, we love patterns. Patterns are an essential part of learning, and we evolve to recognize them because they help us predict and expect what is coming next. Patterns are the key of survival. Our love for music might not have a biological purpose. Maybe it's just an emergent and collateral effect of us being patterns addicts.
You look like Zorro now.
Ha! En garde! Sé que tu verdadero nombre es Don Diego de la Vega.
Oh no! ¿Cómo es esto posible?
How can an animal be emotional?
The problem with the term emotion is that it has a very vague definition. As a neuroscientist, I think of emotion as a state of the neural system in reaction to a meaningful stimulus. Emotions appeared through evolution, and they have helped us adapt faster and survive. Basic emotions like fear and joy probably appeared first. Then other emotions like pride or shame evolved with the emergence of sociality in animals. Emotions are neurological reactions. Emotions are physical. You can measure them looking at the heart rate, facial expressions, brain activity, for example. But, big but, if we can measure the physical state of an emotion, it is almost impossible to measure the conscious experience of an emotional reaction, because that is a subjective feeling. We can communicate what we feel between humans, but we cannot talk to animals. Because of this, we can find analogous emotional states in other animals, but we cannot be 100% sure of what exactly they are experiencing, what exactly they are feeling. Regardless of the fact that some animals might have feelings or not, it is important to always respect all living creatures.
I tried to make a raccoon, but it really doesn't look like a raccoon.
Why do we cry when we are sad?
I'm assuming that by crying you mean water coming out of your eyes. Why do we do that when we're sad or stressed? We are the only animals that do that. And from a survival point of view, that is a very weird thing to do, because it doesn't seem very advantageous to sob and cry in a situation of distress. Imagine your vision becoming blurry and having convulsive gasps in a situation of life or death. I know it's not very intuitive, but tears can help us survive, and this is because we are social animals. For us, communication is a key feature for survival, and having a universal way of communicating to the others that we are having a hard time is an advantageous feature. Humans are empathetic, and expressing signs of weakness can help us generate social bonds, and those bonds are even stronger in times of vulnerability. We try to express weaknesses and vulnerability, but crying itself is an evolutionary strength. I hope you enjoyed this quack, and if you have any super cool and interesting question, just drop a comment below. I'll see you very soon.